Hello, everyone, and welcome to Biped. I got this game a couple of sales ago because I thought it looked cute. I wonder if I get to choose which one I get to be, by the way. Like, if I do, though, I want to be the orb, because I think that's just adorable. And I will sit through this intro because, I know that I skipped the forest one, because that just kind of seemed boring and I wanted to get through the game. Well, not boring per se, I just wanted to play the game, but like, colorful, stuff. I'm always interested in like, what's going on in the world and how it came to be what it is. I'm surprised. Like, I thought it was gonna be a little longer than that, but you know, this is technically what people would call a kid's game, I guess. Alright. Hello, Space Helper Bot. We need to run some basic setups before plunging to the blue planet. Okay. Ooh. Okay. It's a little weird, but not as weird as everyone else has said. I'm trying to move the other leg, though. How do I... Okay. It's doing it in weird stages. You know... Do you, Oh, that's weird. Like, it's not like you can, It's not like you can walk in the traditional sense where you can just, put the right stick up and then the left stick and kind of do it in a regular rhythm. It's like... It does this weird swinging thing, like, this weird momentum. I feel like before I am fully used to this, I feel like I'm gonna be... Did I already say the thing about walking in a stupor? And, like, I know this is a puzzle game, but, like, the first puzzle is learning how to walk in the first place. It is a little floaty. Yeah? Oh. Okay, so not like down as in pressed in, but like, you know, I almost kind of wonder if this is messing up because my controller is drifting, because I know that, like, my console does that. And I knew for a fact that if I, if it was messing up, that this game, I wouldn't be able to, okay, wait, hold on. Now I'm getting the hang of it a little. Ooh, this is fun. I've always thought this would be cool. You know that, Petco commercial or whatever it was, where it had the huge, hamster playground kind of thing, the tubes all over the store, kind of like, you know, when restaurants have the play place for the kids. I always thought that would be really cool to just, like, mess around in. I'm surprised that, well, I guess not really surprised too much in this world that we don't have as many fun things like that, but, like, we should integrate more fun and creativity and, you know, colorful playfulness into our lives. Well, yeah.
Hmm.
Oh, cool. Your feet can handle a variety of things. Use them often. It's not like you have many other tools to use anyway. I don't know if that was just an insult or trying to use it as a fact. What, you can't... Okay, so you can't skate on the gray, but, alright. Can I... Cool. It's almost like, instead of, is that how I need to start understanding this? That you can't just move your leg forward, you have to swing it the way that it needs to be? 'Cause, oh no, what is this? Wait, wait. Ah, did I miss out on that? Oh, what is this? This is very, like, you know, old Nintendo-esque kind of music, kind of feel. A star? What's this supposed to be, Mario? Do I know how to open the gate? Maybe? Okay, good. Walking seems to be a little easier. Like, I think just at the start, they purposely hold you back. Did I already say it kind of feels like Portal? Am I, like, I feel like I'm just losing memory by the pound, by the second. Like, No! I tried to swing my leg back over. I thought I was walking straight. Well, if that is the case, that, you know, this kind of blank space also makes... Oh, I thought I could get around that way. What, I can't, like, step on here? Or can I? Okay, cool. It makes me think of, Control and that, like, astral plane. I wonder if I'm gonna be able to play Control, on this channel. 'Cause I think that would be really fun. That would be really cool. Just push me ahead. Alright, I dig that. Ooh. I almost kind of wondered if that was going to hurt me in any way, because security lights are never a good thing. Oh, do I just... I thought it would push me forward by itself. Well, that's kind of cheap. So, what is our big incentive to get the coins anyway? Is it just, like, hearkening back to the old ways of collectathons? Or, oh yeah, sure. I took forever. It's almost like I was made with weird mechanics. The real challenge has just started, oh no. What am I up to? What am I looking forward to, I guess? Travel to Earth and reactivate the beacons. The galaxy depends on you. So, what are the beacons for? Is this kind of like a whole Wally situation, or like... Okay. Oh. So, that kind of seems backwards, because, like, if you're activating beacons, isn't that usually to, like, contact aliens or something? Why are aliens coming here to... Hmm? Dense forest. Yeah, I feel kind of dense right now. I do. I mean, not just in this game, but like... all over. Just all around. Oh, this is really cool. This, does anybody remember, I think it was called Pac-Man World Adventure 2, the second one for PS2. I used to play all the time as a kid, and it's like, wow, what is all this? After the storm, the beacon here went out. Now everyone is panicking. The beacons are what light up the Earth for the galaxy travelers. You must have heard this a million times, but it is my duty to brief you anyway. We have come to Earth to build these paths that connect the beacons around the planet, so when there is a problem, you can quickly get to the beacons and reactivate them. It's not easy, but I'm sure you will have no problem finding the way. What else do I remember? Like, robots coming back to fix the planet for it wasn't. It wasn't Wally, it was something else, and now that's gonna be. It's gonna be plaguing my mind for a little bit. I don't know if it was like a game or a. Like an anime. And grab. Ooh, nice. Very interesting.